Welcome back to the playthrough of Resident Evil. I'm recording a couple of different sessions. The first run, I didn't get to see where it entered off. It cut me off. It might have cut me off. I'm not positive. We're going to go back and try to play this some more. We were in the process of... I dropped this off. I'm sorry about the coughing and what have you. Once I get excited and start talking really quick and what have you, and it's like a mix of laughing and choking, and that's why I cough a lot. I'm sorry if you got headset on and you get a bunch of coughing and whatnot, but I am sorry about that. It's not Corona or COVID. It's not neither of them. So what were we doing here? I got the small key. We can come back up here and do this. Nobody in my family has got COVID yet, which is a great thing. The mask issue is... it's fine, but it is getting kind of the point where, oh my god, I gotta wear my mask to go into the store, to everywhere, pretty much anywhere and everywhere out in public. It feels like a chore, but I know it's a good thing that everybody is doing that. Yeah, you can have all your opinions. Come on, this is a stupid camera angle. I'm gonna go in here and unlock this door. But I'm hoping that everybody is staying safe out there and doing what they need to do to keep safe. The main thing that I'm getting sick and tired of doing is making sure I wash everything prior to opening it up, cleaning it up. And yeah, it's to the point where if you go get a pop can, a soda can, beer cans, pop bottles, you name it, I'm kind of a freak when it comes to that type of stuff, where it's got to be sanitary, got to be clean. The gas pumps, I'll make sure I touch everything. Everything that I touch the first time and out there, I try not to touch my face and touch too much of my truck or whatever, and then I'll wipe my door handle on the outside of my truck, make sure I grab a sanitary hand wipe and hand sanitizer. I don't want to press that button yet. Yeah, okay. I know that this connects to this. Okay. Over here goes the fish hook looking one. So that one goes there, and this one here, yeah, nothing happened, of course. Yes, we go grab this so we can use this later. And he comes alive. That's great. Where is... yeah. Let's get that and get out of here. Let that be. Let that wasp be in here. Forever and ever. Yeah, I'll wash my hands and hand sanitize myself and the whole nine after taking and doing the gas pump and touching everything and this and that. I don't have one of those touch tools. I was thinking about making one for myself. We'll get a sheet of brass or a piece of brass and cutting one up those non-touchable hooks. What was I gonna do next? Let's just get the cutscene done and over with. Because you go back over there and have to get the serum and whatnot.
You.
Chris Redfield, Alpha Team. We're here to rescue you. Richard, what the hell happened to you?
Got jacked up.
Chris, this place. Get your team out of here. Demons everywhere.
Don't talk. He seems to have been bitten by a poisonous snake, but the size of the bite mark is huge.
It's not just any ordinary snake. Take my word for it.
It's a big anaconda.
I left it in another room.
I'll go get it.
She sounds so glassed over.
Hold on. I'll be back.
I left it in another room. I'm sorry. She sounds so glassed over. She does. She sounds glassed over. Like she's so high. It showed you where to go. But it's over here in this area. We've been there. It's the other save room on the other side of the... other side of the mansion. But you got 4 minutes to do this. I'm not sure exactly what happens if you're too late. And like, you go get the serum and you shoot it in the whole nine and you blow your chances to getting the serum. I don't know if he just dies there and Rebecca kind of becomes a real Karen towards you, but I'm not positive. But she kind of looks all glassed over like Scooby-Doo. I left it in another room. I'm sorry. Can you become a errand boy and get it for us? Because I can't carry him. Whatever. She's all glassed over all the time. Which is kind of... I don't care. Let's go get this. It's in this room. And you come back to this room after you go and get the serum. Because then she makes you help her carry him back here. So we'll go back over through here. But yeah, I'm kind of OCD on that whole getting the pandemic. I don't really want to get that. It's just sounds like a big headache. And then there's the other fact of, well, do I have it? Do I not have it? Do I go get tested? And if you already feel that bad, and that ill feeling at this point in time, you should just assume that you have it. If you feel that bad, you should just assume that you have it, go get tested and protect yourself and what have you. But if you feel that bad, you should just assume that you had it or have it and try to quarantine yourself and keep yourself away from people. Because that stuff spreads
Thank
like
you.
Wildfire.
I'm gonna give you a shot now, Richard. Hang in there.
Here. Take it. It's a radio. Take care of yourself, Rebecca. Richard.
He's okay. He's just unconscious.
Rebecca. It's not safe here. let's get Richard to a safer place.
Right.
So it's my idea to take him. It's not even her idea.
Richard's doing well, Chris. He should recover soon.
Good. Richard needs you now.
As soon as Richard gets better, we'll come after you.
Rebecca, you okay with a gun?
Yes.
All right. I'm going to continue my investigation.
Be careful. Okay?
She basically gives you a free heal in here anytime you come in here. But considering the fact that I've already got that, what we're going to do is we're going to go back and do the piano room now. So that's... let's go this way real quick. I'll unlock that door real quick. That'll help me with the rest of the hoopla. And I probably run into finding other keys and all that because I gotta give her time to learn the piano eventually anyway, so we'll take care of that. So we'll come down here and we'll unlock this door. So we're here. I should go back and burn that guy. I really should go burn that guy. He's probably gonna go necro the second I walk through there. There's that other room there. I gotta pick up a key in there. There's a grenade on the table. I gotta pick up too. What was I doing? Oh, getting fuel. Fuel's this way. I'm kind of spacing out here a little bit there and this and that. After I'm done recording this one, I gotta wake up Tammy and start doing other. I don't even have it, really. I gotta go back and get the kerosene container. It's a lot of backtracking with Chris. A lot of backtracking. But yeah, we gotta go and do a bunch of stuff outside and get prepped and ready to go for winter.
This room is equipped with all sorts of medical supplies. I could pretty much treat any wound. Want me to treat your wounds?
No, thank you. I'm good.
No, I'm okay. But if something should happen to me, I'm counting on you.
No problem. But we're very short on medical supplies, so take care of yourself.
Where is it? Up here. So we're gonna grab this. I'm gonna be jetting. I'm gonna go get some fuel, cook that zombie, get him out of the way, and then I'm gonna go to that other room. Hopefully don't go necro on me. I've got 12 bullets in the thing, that's fine. I'm not sure how many different people take that COVID virus seriously. I'm not really sure. That's kind of an interesting topic. But I don't want to get too involved into it and politically into it. Is it real? Is it not real? But I believe that it is because it's just I'm kind of OCD on that whole thing. It's one of those things I'd rather not catch it. Just supposed to catch it now, cause it doesn't sound fun. It just doesn't. So we're gonna go down here and burn this guy. Too far away still. I know he's gonna look at his hands. He's gonna necro. Yep. Guess what I'm gonna do anyway. Burn you anyway. Alright, anyway, I don't need to stand there and stare at the fire. It's just a burned zombie, whoopee-doo. Oh man, I can't even do this. I gotta go back through that other area and go and open that other door. All the way back up to where that snake is. So I can't even do this. I forgot about that. It's where Richard was. So I might as well just do a bunch of other stuff around here. Because Richard's already in the storage room. In the save room, getting help by Rebecca. So I might as well just do a few things in here. I could burn this guy right now, I think. Yep, see, that's what I'm talking about. Take a hit in health because I didn't walk far enough away. There's a paper on here. There's obviously somebody in that closet that's behind me. This one's just basically some kind of journal about what happened to a set of people during their experience of catching the T-virus and getting the T-virus and becoming infected. I figured Resident Evil for Halloween would be more suiting for the what's going on politically in the world right now with getting infected and coming down with the virus, and it just kind of suiting to me. I think anyway. Let you just head pop ya. There's a key in here, I think. Yep. So that's the third. That's the fourth key, I believe it is. So we could either come back through here to get all this stuff out of the way and do that. Probably should. I picked that up already. So we're gonna go get stuff for that plant. That I picked up outside earlier, that white bag of it's like fertilizer type stuff. So we're gonna come over here and pick that up, and I'll probably get rid of the canteen thing, cause there's another mask in that room that I gotta go to. The original is not bad. I like the remake a lot, yes, but you can't get any. The original to me is, you know, it was a good game when I was growing up. I like the remake. It is kind of cool. I bought this remake for a lot of my systems. Got it for GameCube. Got it for 360. Got it for the PS4 now. I've been debating about getting it for my Switch, but I don't really want to pay arm and leg for it, then pay for DLC content on top, or the get it downloadable and whatnot. It's not the fact that I can't put it on my Switch, it's just I don't need Resident Evil on everything, I don't think. So we're going to turn it to the red. I don't really know what happens if you turn it to green, but it turned the water to red. So I'm gonna spray the water out of the water fountain red, and then I'm not gonna take any chances of going back out there when that's spraying all over the place. I don't know if that kills a plant, that's gonna probably kill me. So this is another death mask. So we're gonna take that. There's a bunch of herbs in here. I'm not gonna pick the herbs up if I don't absolutely have to have them. Most of the time I won't, so I'm not gonna worry too much about it. They're gonna come busting through this. Yeah, it won't matter much. Let's go over this way. So that guy's gone, which is good. I don't want to go into there because I can't do any of that because I gotta go back up to where Richard was. If I pick up that death mask and use that key, then I could get rid of that. Okay, so then that'll help. So we'll go this way. I'm gonna go up stairs and around. Man, I can't do that neither. So I'd have to would have to go back that way. That would be only one time going through that door. So that wouldn't be too bad, I don't think. Going one time through that doorway that way, I don't think will be that big of a deal. So we'll go that way. Oh, you're gonna be in here? Oh, guess what? Let's see if I kill you. I don't really want. You gonna walk through here or what? Probably should just swap this over. Swap this over and use one of those. That'll blow his head off. Maybe I should do that. Come on, get up. Get up. Get up. Go. I'm gonna let you chew on this. Oh no, he uses the knife. I swapped that, man. Alright, so that was kind of lame. Blow his head off. Blow his head off. Let's see it. Or I shoot it. Okay. So, we'll, I just want to get rid of this. Just because I could get rid of this. So let's take care of this. I didn't go get that literature that's on that table in that other room for that wraparound, but we'll be coming back there anyway, I know it. So, I've played this before, so it's not, like I said, it's one of my favorite games, so it's not that big of a deal. We can throw that there. We don't necessarily need to do that, but for some reason, the game doesn't make you do that, but I did it anyway. And then we got the upstairs map, which you can tell that there's quite a bit still throughout the area. I don't know if I'm gonna take and get everything everywhere to make everything green. But we have the upstairs map now, so that's out of the way, and then we don't have to worry about picking that up anymore. So we'll come back through here. There's a lot of herbs in that area, but like I said, we were going to come down here and we'll probably go through that door once. Key, death mask. I gotta drop that metal plate off. Cause I don't wanna keep walking around with that metal plate if I don't absolutely have to. We got two death masks. I'm gonna grab this. Use the small key, get rid of the death mask. So there'll be three death masks. Let's just do that. I want to place them down there, so all I gotta do is carry one death mask with me and then probably extra help after it's all said and done. Like I said, this is one-way door. If you limit yourself to only a few times using this door, this way it will never break on you to the point where it's gonna be a loop around all the time, and then that's... But, you know, knowing me, it's gonna be a loop around. And I didn't never burn this zombie, so... The best way to do this is get this out of the way to get the loop around done. So you wanna change this to orange. So this is the code. So you change this one to the orange. That's the very first painting. You press any other buttons in a different order, the birds come down and get you. Because they're like, oh, you pressed the wrong button. So the very first painting with lighting, you gotta change it orange. The yellow one here on the very end of, after you turn around here, will, it's yellow. You gotta hit this button. It will turn green. Okay. Okay. And then the very next painting that's red here, you want to change this to purple. Okay. And if you come down here and look at this painting without pressing the button, you can get the justification to which one is which. Because one painting will have a bracelet, the other one will have a necklace, the other one will have a headpiece. And that's how you would tell which one would need to be what color. But like I said, if you change the wrong switch in the pattern, the birds already come down and get you anyway. And then you gotta reset the room every time. But if you do it this way every time you come in here, if you were to play for this game for yourself, it wouldn't matter. I've got extra room so I could pick this mask up. And the small key that I'm going to use for the last small key is over here. There's one more death mask that we got to get, and that's up by the snake. But I'm gonna put all three of these in the faces right now, so they're just out of my inventory. I got confused there. Now each of these mask holes down here will tell you where to place them, or you could just kind of button mash. I believe it's that one. And this one is the nose one. I'm not sure which one's left out of the whole deal. I'm pretty sure that the solid face one goes over on the corner. So which one do I have? Solid face one or eye one? Yeah, so it's this one. I believe it's this one. Yeah. So the last one that you're looking for, or that we'll get, is this one here. But that's up by the snake. So considering that I got all that done, we're going to reload here real quick, and then I'm going to go back through that doorway that I just came out of. Because now this will be a decent wraparound to go back and forth to bypass that hallway that I don't want to go through ever again. So, like I said, you don't shoot in here whatsoever, because the birds will come after you. Down in here. Just don't shoot. It's just that simple. He's still not Necro. He'll more than likely end up Necro, because I didn't burn him or whatever. But what we're gonna do is, like you said, like I said, you can always go through that way without having to worry about anything. I have a lighter, so that's not a big deal. We gotta go and get. Now, considering that the fact that that zombie is dead and gone, I wonder if he'll be in the hallway. Because he's supposed to stand in that hallway and be nemesing right where he got bit. Yeah, so he's not even in here. That's cool. So that's done and over with. Yet again, I don't know when I started playing this game, so I gotta really start taking time to recognize the time before I start recording. So we'll go in here, and then there is a light over here. We got to use the lighter. There's like three or four places that you could use the lighter at. And yeah, let's just pop your head off. I'm gonna get that done and out of the way. I'm glad I got a head popper on that one. No, Chris, don't push it that way. Oh man, you're gonna have to reset the. You're gonna have to reset the room, aren't you? Nope. You are so lucky on that one, Chris. No. I don't really want to bother with him. Let's get the music. No. Let's just go. Let's just get it over with. Let's just get out of here. Leave him alone. He could just, on and on and on. We're gonna come back here anyway, because you gotta get a key for that door. It's one special key for that door. So what we'll do is we'll come through here. I don't need no health. All right, I gotta swap this back. Even though I use that stupidly, but I'm glad that the zombie's out of the way, because the zombie stands on the other side of the pool and you gotta go around where those herbs are to get around him. That's the easiest way to do it. Now that I've got the music, let's go down and take care of the piano. So we'll go down here and take care of the piano so I can get the key, so we can take care of the snake, which is called Yawn. Back through here. We're gonna end up coming back through here, and we're gonna pick up a bunch of stuff anyway. So get a bunch of stuff down here. But we're gonna go through here. Now, there's a bunch of different type of stuff here. There's ink ribbons there on the bar. But we want to come down here and push this shelf out of the way. We want to take this. This is so tedious here. It's kind of cool, but it's kind of tedious, because back in the day, it's like I don't really remember this puzzle too much, but it's so funny how you got music notes, and then you got this book. You got to put the music into the book, and then take the book and use it on the piano. Scared the hell out of him.
Rebecca.
That sounded like Moonlight Sonata.
Can you play?
Interpretation is off a little. Let me practice for a while.
Yeah, you sure. Want to say yes.
But don't get too carried away.
Oh, I won't.
She sounds so over undramatic. Hey, oh no. I won't. It won't matter, because I'm so baked. It's so bizarre. She's so glassed over. So messed up. I don't know if that's way that they wanted to portray her to be, and so like, yeah, okay, that type of thing. I don't know. She's so glassed over. So we've got that one thing in this, that the one thing that's above the fireplace, and we've got the blue gem. We can come out here and go back in, and technically we could go back over to Rebecca and take care of that, which I might just do anyway. And get that done and over with, and then come back and go get the shotgun shells. Because I'm going to take shotgun up there to yawn. Because I'm not going to play around. I'm not going to play screw around with the handgun.
Chris, I think I got it.
This makes perfect.
What's this?
Did she say anything else? Did she say anything else?
Be careful, Chris.
So she's nervous at the fact that I'm gonna come in here. Okay. Which is on the other side of that glass there, that one mask was. There's mainly more literature. I'm sorry, I went a little bit fast on a couple of those. But yeah, it's some of the literature. I mean, yeah, if you want to read up on it, yeah, you could do that, or pick somebody else's playthrough to look through that. But you take the gold one out, the door closes. And then if you don't have, like, it's the same principle as those keys. If you don't have the other one with you, then you gotta place it back, because in the original game, I just picked up a bunch of different stuff to see what would happen and this and that. It was very interestingly weird. She does say something. I want to talk to her again.
Were you all right in there?
Yeah.
No, I just was hanging out, smoking your dope. Without you. Such glassed over. Just such glassed over. Scooby-Doo. She acts like a Belma. No, we want to go. No, we want to go through here. That guy, there's a necro zombie in there. I think it's just because of the fact that he was... they busted through or whatever. And I gotta take care of my headset here. Okay. My headset's kind of being like the... Okay. Now, in order to do this, the clock obviously turned on, but the code here is this one. The long hand goes to the head. And the other one is to the chest, which is the smaller one. That's the code for the clock. And my headset wants to be stupid right at the moment. Really staticky. I don't know if you guys are even hearing me now. So we'll go through this real quick. You want the small hand, or small, which is wrong, of course, but you want small wheel. I want to turn it back to the right. Alright, so we're going to leave the small one there. But it's awkward because it's backwards. So you want the long one. Turn it to the left. You want the long one. Turn it to the left. And then... no. You want to leave. I'm not too sure when I started this game, so, or started this LP session, so I think what we'll do is we'll reload this, and I'll go get the shotgun shells. I gotta take care of this headset. This headset's staticky, crackling, and I really gotta change his headset. I'm hoping you guys hear this, because I don't want to do this again. Okay. So we'll go in here. Get rid of the blue jet. And this tiger head. It takes two different types of gems. It takes a yellow one and a blue one. You have to come here regardless anyway, so you might as well just go and put the blue one in anyway. I mean, you could do this later or earlier. I'd prefer to do it earlier, so then you got extra hand or extra shotgun shells. Well, now my headset wants to stop crackling. Oh man, I hope you guys can hear me. That would really suck if you couldn't, or it's actually not recording. That would really suck too. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. I'll go around you. We're gonna go over here. And we're gonna get prepped and set. And I'll probably save before we even do yawn. I'm kind of bumming about the whole headset deal. I really hate the fact that it crackles. It's an old headset. So we're gonna go get that. Put that in there. We're gonna go do the shotgun. And let's get rid of the handgun. And that. Alright, so what we're going to do is we're going to take these three things. Oh, we gotta grab some health. Let's be on the safe side. Let's shot it up. I'm thinking about doing yawn and getting yawn out of the way. The headset's kind of being wonky. I don't want to cut this video short. I really don't want to cut this video short if I don't absolutely have to. I don't know when I started either, so that's not a good thing. I don't want to have like a 15 minute video of trying to play freaking Resident Evil and I didn't get anywhere. Kinda be depressing. I want to get yawn out of the way. I'd like to. I'm hoping this does, otherwise I'm gonna have to take and redo this whole thing. It's not like I've never had to do that before. Okay. Maybe that's what I gotta do. I just gotta keep water around so my throat don't get all dried out and coughing, hacking, and having fun. Maybe that's what I gotta do. Alright, when I go in here and get this done, a cutscene will play, and as long as I don't get bit by him, I won't have to become Rebecca. But if I get bit by him, I gotta become Rebecca. So I'm hoping I don't get bit. Okay. So we'll come over here, grab the shotgun shells. We do have shotgun on us. Alright, so let's go and activate yawn. You're not gonna bite me. You're not gonna bite me. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Don't bite me, don't bite me. Oh, I think I might have gotten away with it. We'll see. He won't do the whirly thing. Nope. That's nice. That is awesome. Alright, cool. So then, yawn's out of the way. That should be the last mask. We'll check and see if there was anything else in that room. No, that room was cleared. All the rest of these things here, left and right, are like herbs and such. But alright, yawn's done. Good. Now I've got more than enough. Let's just go and get that other mask done right now. Let's go get that mask done. Let's go get that mask done. Do it up. Mask, mask, mask. We go this way. We'll just go this way. Now I don't have to go through that door the opposite way. And I'm not gonna save. I'm not. I've got more than enough bullets. There's a big coffin hanging off that chain, and you see those chains that were breaking? Well, there's somebody in that coffin. Obviously. So we're gonna go down and take care of that. I've got health. It's like one boss battle right after another boss battle. I didn't shoot Yon, so. Let's get rid of this mask. Oh man, really? Oh, it's this one? Yeah, it's this one. Huh, I thought it was the opposite one. Alright, my bad. Oh, here comes the coffin. We ready to rock? Let's go. Let's go. Oh, I'll pick. It's not gonna. It's gonna take me to the cutscene. Alright, so the gauge comes down. We're gonna jack him up. Oh, come on. Don't play me like that, bruh. Get up. You're not done yet. Door didn't open. Alright, that was a waste. That one bullet was a waste. Yeah, I'm gonna refill it anyway, just to be on the safe side. Yeah, let's refill it real quick. Pick up that. Get out of here. Let's get out of here. Now we gotta come over here. I don't know when I started. I'm really hoping I don't know. It don't cut off on me. I'm really hoping. But we've got that gem. Now we need it for the outside door to head towards the courtyard. That gem, that is. Or that amulet or emblem. Whatever you want to call it. Emblem. That umbrella emblem. There's a dog in here that. I should really go back and save before I do all this, so I can go get that. Oh, come on, really? Dog. Let me go, dog. Come back through here real quick. I might. I didn't even use that health. Oh, well. We'll grab that. These shotgun shells. So we got those shotgun shells. There's a grenade here. Grab the grenade, Chris. We're gonna come back through here anyway. Oh, I don't want to do this, Chris. Don't. I want to go back and get that other. Go back and get that other emblem. Well, it's not like I can't go back this way and come back. Well, either way, I'm gonna do some. I need that health spray. Health spray. Let's go through here. Let's get this code done and out of the way. Go through the courtyard. Okay. The code here is the red one's gonna be on west. No.
Respond. Wesker? Once you're in chains. Retreat. Not exist. Wave. Woods outside the mansion.
So something's going on outside of the mansion. We didn't quite catch all that. The red one you want on west, and this blue one here, which is spinning completely out of control, you want it on north. It unlocks the door. So then you don't have to worry about going back up through, back and forth, back and forth. As long as you leave those where they are and they don't spin or any of that such, you're good. I'm not going to take care of these crows yet. We take care of the crows when we come back through. Oh, come on, seriously, don't be doing stupid stuff like that. Don't fly right in my face like that. Don't be starting that. Now there's this old creepy chick, right? You can hear her in the background with the chains. Well, that's good old Lisa. We'll find out who she is in a few minutes. What you want to do is you want to go this way, and then up this way, and over this way. It's a big wraparound right through there. I'm not gonna. Well, wait. I can go get that health. I don't wanna use these herbs or these health sprays because I already had to play one with dumb, with just getting rid of it. I wanna keep them. I don't wanna use them very often. So all we'll do is we'll go through here. This isn't the old mansion. It's just the cabin. Oh, excuse me. I don't know if you guys heard that or what it is. Or what was going on. Oh, there's a... Chris! There's a map. Pick it up. Alright, it tells you that we still have other stuff in the house here, in that way, same as before. Maps hasn't changed, it's just more of the map. What we will do is, I think I'm going to place this, and this, and then we're going to go grab some. Gotta grab that. We're gonna grab the ribbons real quick. And I think I'm gonna save because I don't know when I started and it's already 15 after. So what we're going to do is we're going to save up after we read this ripped piece of paper. It talks about Lisa and what's going on. Lisa Trevor. A little bit about Lisa Trevor. But we're gonna save up here and we're gonna call it a good for the second hour, or hopefully the second hour of doing this LP. Hopefully I don't have to worry about redoing that, because I'm gonna go 7 and then 8 and then back and forth if I don't have to re-record this. So hopefully I don't have to re-record this. So I'm gonna save up and we'll call it good for this video, and